Call to action, CTA. Sometimes people call these CTAs, implying the plural is call to actions. Of course, the plural of call to action is calls to action, like attorneys general or mothers-in-law. We're going to use a form block and a simple grid to create a scalable call to action. And to get started, we'll add a section. To do that, we'll just drag in a section. We'll drag it underneath the brands section. Now, with this, the brand section we created before, we already have some properties we can apply to this one. So let's choose brand section, the existing class, which already has that top and bottom padding applied. Now, if we change something like the background color to one of these elements, it'll apply to both because the same class is applied. Let's undo that and instead create a combo class. This combo class is more specific. So for contact, we'll change the background color and it's not going to change the other section. Of course, as we're used to, let's drag in a container to keep all of our contents neatly bound. And we'll also go down and drag in a form block. This form block contains all the elements we'll need to create our form. We're going to remove the field labels and write inside of each text field directly. So we'll double click and adjust the placeholder, your name. Double click, adjust the placeholder, your email. Finally, we can make a change to the submit button. Double click that, edit the text, and instead we can make it say something like start the conversation. Let's grab a heading to drag right into our container, and sometimes this can be a little tedious to do on the canvas. So we'll go over to the navigator and let go there. Let's change this heading to an H2 as well, and once we're done with that, we can change the text. Let's add a subheading. Now there are several elements we can use to do this. Let's in this case use a text block, and we'll drop that right underneath the heading. And we can double click, paste in, we have some copy we already wrote, and now we can do our grid-based layout. And we'll use a grid element. The grid element we can drag right into the form itself and let go. And once that's positioned, we can go ahead and remove our first row. We only need one row, but we do need four columns. So we'll add two more. Let's drag in our first text field. Let's drag in our second text field. And let's drag in the submit button. Now, you'll see a little space at the bottom here, 10 pixels. We can change that by simply clicking the 10, changing it to 0, and we can apply that same class that was automatically created to this text field as well. Now everything is spaced evenly. Now what happens when we move in our text? The heading looks fine, but when we drag in the text block, things start to overlap. That's expected behavior, and here's how we can deal with it. We can use a div block as a wrapper. Drag the div block into that cell, and we'll create a class for this. Just to keep everything organized, we'll call it wrapper, and that wrapper can contain two other items, the ones we just put in. We'll drag in the heading, and we can do the same thing with the text block. We can put the text block right underneath our heading. Speaking of headings, let's select our heading and make a change to the style. Now, if you remember, we created a specific style for this before, a smaller heading. So we can apply that to this one. We'll tweak that in a second, but let's use our paragraph style as well. We can click our text block, take a look at this paragraph above, we called that paragraph, and we can apply paragraph to this text block. So we'll type in paragraph and select. Almost done. With our grid parent selected, we can make changes to alignment. In this case, we'll go over to vertical and we can set it to the start, which will put everything on the top. We can set it to the end, which will put everything on the bottom, but we'll leave ours at center. Now let's change the styling on smaller heading. We can add a combo class here, basing it on the original smaller heading class. And what we'll do is change three things. First, we'll change the color to a more teal color. This is already part of our palette. We'll change the font to bold, and we'll change the alignment to the left. While we're adjusting styling, let's do the same thing on the submit button. We'll create a gradient, two stops. Each of the stops can be one of our brand colors, so we can keep everything uniform. And we can adjust the angle here as well. Just drag to adjust the angle. Visually, it plays nice with the hero section. Now, in the hero section, these buttons are rounded. They have rounded edges. So let's do the same thing with the submit button. Let's go down and change the radius to 4 pixels as well. Let's make sure to do the same thing to the text field class. We'll add rounding 4 pixel radius so everything is uniform. And that's a straightforward structure for a grid-based call to action. In the next video, we'll make sure it functions well on tablets and mobile devices.